For cheap and reliable FIFA coins, go to golda.com. Check out the link in the description.
What's up guys, I'm Tomal FC Evan and welcome back to the Liverpool Career Mode series. First of all, thank you so much for all your support throughout the whole series, throughout season 1, season 2, and in particular season 3. We had an amazing season and you guys can make it even better next season if you keep up the support and smash the likes. And guys, the Player Awards show will be in the next episode and I want you guys to get involved. So vote in the comments below, who was your player of the season in season 3, who was your best defender, midfielder, attacker, who was also your favorite young player who you think did the best, like under 21, under 23 player of the season. Also, which was the match of the season, if you can remember. And also, who was the most improved player and who was the signing of the season? Also, let me know in the comments below. But first, before we get into the episode, I wanted to award the comment of the day to one of the most amazing comments that I got on my channel. It goes to Callum Burns. You can see it on the screen. He has been watching my videos since FIFA 13. And he noticed the improvement in quality, the passion, and everything else, and he notices also that I act in every video that you guys matter, the subscribers matter, and it's like talking to my friends, guys. You guys, I consider you guys my friends. You guys have been involved in my life so much in the past 4 years, and I'm forever grateful for all the support and all the everything that you have given me. Sorry for the lack of FIFA videos in the past few days. This fever has been killing me, but I'm getting better, so you can expect a lot more FIFA videos from now on. Tomorrow all my FIFA series will be back, so expect 4 or 5 FIFA videos tomorrow. So yeah, I think goalkeeper of the season, and I think maybe signing of the season could be Leno, even though we only signed him in January. He kept 14 clean sheets in 27 games. Just take a look at that. I think the signing of the season could be between Leno and Lacazette. Let me know who do you think is the signing of the season in the comments below. Also, Demarcus, Nkuru, Vertonghen. Wow, they already went up again. Amazing. Just in the last day of the season, they were 85 rated players. Now they are 86, which is brilliant. Also, Moreno is improving very nicely. And yeah, I'm very happy with the squad, but we can make it even better. Like 83-84% of you guys said I should bring back Luis Suarez in the straw poll vote. Keep voting. I think I will leave the link to that in the video's description, just like in the previous episode. But yeah, many of you guys said I should bring back Luis Suarez. I will try my best to do that. I hope the same doesn't happen to him what happened to me when I tried to sign Ibrahimovic in my Barcelona career, that because of previous history, Ibra just refused any contract that I threw at him. And yeah, there were some, like, yeah, I wanted to mention this guy, Lacazette. What a signing. And even if we get Luis Suarez, don't worry guys, I will rotate the team, so Lacazette won't automatically drop to the bench. I will just switch it up. Don't forget that Sherdan Shaqiri comes in as a free signing, a pre-contract agreement. He will join us next season. So we will have an amazing attacking talent, array of talent, and we will need it definitely, because you know, we fell short in the Champions League last season. Bayern Munich really brushed us aside. By the way, if you are wondering where Xabi Alonso is and where some of the young players are, I had to terminate Xabi Alonso's contract to sign some of the youth academy players, but you know, I might try and re-sign him in the summer, maybe, not too sure. But you know, in the first half of the season Xabi Alonso played really well, but in the second half of the season, by the way, Sturridge is still injured, you know, Xabi Alonso's rating went down and down and down, and I thought, you know, he's not really playing, so I could release him, because then I didn't want the youth academy to get glitched, and yeah, I still need to free up some space in the squad. As you can see, we have 38 players at the moment, and if I want to make signings, well, I think I will release this guy maybe the goalkeeper, you know, because goalkeepers don't really grow until they are like 24, 25 years old on this year's FIFA. So what I usually do is like, I release this guy and then I go to the search players menu and bang, here it is, as you can see, and then I just add him in the into the shortlist, so maybe I can pick him up later. Hopefully a big club or a small club, whatever club, signs him up, and then he will maybe develop into a really good goalkeeper elsewhere. Oh my god, look at this. Do you remember this guy? Joe Osborne. I released him as well because, you know, he couldn't play at us. I couldn't send him out on loan. He was 60 overall in January. What the hell happened to him? He's now 75. This is the Gerrard region, definitely. And I think I will sign him up. Oh my goodness. Just wanted to show you that, you know, I'm keeping on track with these players. We just have, you know, we can only have a squad of 42 players, and you know, you can't really develop everyone at the same time. So I thought, let's release some of these guys and maybe they will grow. Oh my goodness, I'm so excited about this. I honestly, this is my live reaction. I've needn't look at his like stats for like 2 or 3 months in the career mode, and what kind of glitches, and I don't care, but like his physical attributes. So we have already taken a look at the Premier League table. Let's check out all the other tournaments and how we did. So we lost the Community Shield final against Tottenham. You know, I remember when I was testing out the sliders. And by the way, if we manage to sign Suarez, I will bump up the sliders even more, because many of you guys said that I should do that. So don't worry guys, the games will be harder than ever. And yeah, we have been on an amazing run in the FA Cup. We knocked out Chelsea in a replay, so we had to play Chelsea twice in the FA Cup, and then we did the same with Everton. So we basically played Chelsea twice, Everton twice, and then Arsenal. And our reward was a pretty easy semi-final and final. So basically, we basically met the big teams early on. It was a strange FA Cup campaign, that's for sure. And the Chelsea won the League Cup. I'm not too bothered about that. We didn't even make the last 16. And I'm very happy that we could win the European Super Cup, I think for the first time in this series. So here are the FA Cup top scorers. Sturridge finished as the top scorer and we won the competition. Lacazette also had 3 goals and Royce had 3 assists. So this is how the Europa League campaign looks like. And look at this, guys. What an amazing run Everton had in the Europa League. They knocked out Lille and then they knocked out Arsenal 4-1 on aggregate. They knocked out Bruges 4-0. And then they knocked out Saint-Étienne 2-1 in the final. Amazing. And Real Madrid won the Champions League. Wow, Benfica got to the final. That's amazing. So let's take a look at that. So yeah, we got knocked out by Bayern Munich. No shame in that, you know, because Bayern are an amazing team. But we would have met Real Madrid in the semi-final, so that would have been really difficult. So, but I think with the new signings next season, we can have a better tilt at winning the Champions League, because you know that's the holy grail for Liverpool. In the Champions League, Aguero, he killed me. He knocked me out of the Champions League. He scored 2 goals against me, I remember, in the 2 legs. And also Ronaldo, Benzema and Bale, look at that. Wow, there is not even one Liverpool player. Only the one Liverpool player, Royce, in the top 19. But you know, we had a lot of injuries and things like that in the Champions League. We didn't go far in the tournament, so we couldn't score that many goals. So next season, I hope we can improve on that. But that's it for today's episode. Don't forget to leave a vote on the Player of the Season awards, and leave a like if you want to see the next episode too. Thanks for watching, see you later guys, goodbye!